Hi, myself Dr. Nagaratna, a faculty from the National Law School of India University, Bangalore. I'll be now talking about negligent homicide and the possibility of imposing criminal liability under the Indian criminal law framework. Now, the possible section that would attract this particular offence is section 304A. Let's try to understand the extent of application of this provision. But before that, let's go on with the understanding of the concept of mens rea that is involved in this offence, that is negligence and culpable homicide. Before that, it is for us to recollect that negligence is generally considered as both a tort as well as a crime, and criminalization of negligence, however, most often is limited to gross negligence conduct of the accused. Thus, most of the torts might not be criminalized. But what is criminalized might also be considered as a tort. Now, the Indian Penal Code criminalizes negligent acts resulting in injuries and also resulting in death. Negligence under criminal law is in fact treated as a form of mens rea. Negligent homicide is criminalized under all the criminal justice systems, including Indian. The Indian law in fact makes a distinction between culpable homicide and negligent homicide. The courts have also determined various tests that needs to be applicable in order to determine the application of section 304A for an alleged offence of negligent homicide. In fact, there is a variation in the degree of culpability that is attached by the law to reckless homicide and negligent homicide and also culpable homicide. Though it's the same provision, that is Section 304A, which applies both for reckless homicide as well as negligent homicide, there is a variation in the degree of liability that is attached for the two. Courts, in fact, will have to make an inquiry about the extent of mens rea that is involved and the nature of mens rea that is involved in a criminal conduct of an accused. That is, if an offence is committed due to recklessness, the liability is more in comparison to an offence that is committed under mere negligence. Hence, though it's the same provision, that is section 304A of Indian Penal Code, which deals with both, courts have considered the two as distinct while imposing punishment, thereby making reckless homicide a more serious offence than that of negligent homicide. Similarly, courts, while dealing with the cases of medical negligence, also have emphasized upon the difference that exists between mere negligence, which is generally considered as a wrong under civil law, and gross negligence, which is criminalized under the criminal law. Now, the offense of negligent homicide, in fact, includes the deaths that are caused many times due to medical negligence or due to road accidents or due to any such other reckless or negligent conduct on the part of the accused. However, as these are the offences, though that leads to death, lack a specific intention and knowledge to cause the death of the victim, they cannot be categorized as culpable homicide. Being a case of negligently causing death or recklessly causing death, they are considered as a separate category of homicide dealt with in the name of negligent homicide. The offence of negligent homicide, therefore, is the one that falls under section 304A of the Indian Penal Code. As said earlier, road accident cases resulting in death, medical negligent cases resulting in death may all be some of the examples of the cases that may fall under this particular provision. Let's try to understand the conceptual difference that lies between the two terms, negligence and rash act. Under criminal law, negligence, recklessness, rashness are all in fact the terms that refers to varied forms of mens rea, which is in fact an important element of crime. Unless this is proved in a criminal case, a criminal liability cannot be attached. The term negligence implies omission to do something which a reasonable man, guided by those ordinary considerations which ordinarily regulates him or any other human affairs, would do, or doing of something which a reasonable and a prudent man would not do. Hence, negligence refers to doing something that he was not supposed to do or not doing something that he was supposed to do. Hence, it refers to failure to take reasonable care and caution. Negligence also includes doing of some act which a person of ordinary prudence would not have done under a similar situation, or failing to do something which a person of ordinary prudence would have done under that particular situation. Hence, negligence refers to both acts as well as omissions. The mens rea that is required to impose liability under section 304A of Indian Penal Code is either rashness or negligence. The term rash and negligence, though sound similar, yet they have difference under the law. Though both terms are interrelated, yet they are different forms of the same phenomenon, and both in fact refers to the acts that are done without intention. The court has clarified the distinction between these two terms in one of the most important case in India, that is Balachandra Vaman Patte versus State of Maharashtra. The court, through the observation, says that rash act is the one which is a over hasty act done by an accused. It is something that is deliberately done by an accused in spite of knowing the fact that his act is riskier, he still takes up that risk. However, here he doesn't intend or doesn't know that he would be committing the crime. However, he has his knowledge of the risk that is associated with the task that he is undertaking. That is, he knows that the act that which he is doing is riskier and can result in certain injury or even death. Yet, he, by foreseeing that risk, in fact oversees it and takes up that riskier act and ends up committing the offense of negligent or rash homicide. While on the other hand, negligence refers to breach of duty caused by omission to do something which a reasonable man would not do. It also refers to breach of the duty imposed by law. That is, the duty is the one which is imposed upon a person either by an express provision of law or by an implied provision of law. Negligence, in fact, refers to the acts that are done without consciousness that illegal mischievous effect will follow, yet under the circumstances which show that the actor had not exercised the caution incumbent upon him. On the other hand, culpable rashness refers to the acts that are done with consciousness that the mischievous and illegal consequence may follow, but with the hope that they will not. And the criminality in a rash act lies in running the risk of doing such an act with recklessness or indifference towards the consequence. Culpable rashness also includes hazarding a dangerous act or a wanton act with the knowledge that it is so and that it may cause injury, but without intention to cause injury or knowledge that it would probably cause. On the other hand, culpable negligence refers to gross and culpable neglect on the part of the accused or failure to exercise that reasonable and proper care and caution that any other reasonable man would have exercised in order to guard against the injury either to the public in general or to an individual victim in particular, which having regard to all the circumstances out of which the charge has arisen, it was the imperative duty of the accused person to have adopted. So, over here we see that there is failure to exercise due care and caution, or over here we see that there is breach of the duty that is imposed upon a person by the law. The criminality in this case lies in taking the care that, or in rather not taking the care that the law expects him to take.